Jim was born in Mississippi, so he's sort of inherently a Southerner at heart in a way, although he moved back and forth very frequently. His father was an agronomist with the U.S. Department of Agriculture stationed in Beltsville, but was transferred from time to time between Beltsville and Leland, Mississippi, to the Stoneville compound down there, similar compound, but down in Mississippi. So when Jim was very young, they traveled back and forth between Maryland and Washington, D.C. And Jim's grandmother, Dear, lived in Maryland as well. So he had family out here, and he was constantly back and forth. Finally moved here when he was about 10 for good. And the one thing that was really important about being in Maryland is in the early days of television, the Washington, D.C. area had a lot of channels to choose from. They had four. But that was a lot in the early days of TV. And Jim first saw TV in 1949 when he was about 12 or 13 years old. And fell in love with television immediately. And I think part of that, I think what makes Maryland significant there is he was seeing things in Maryland you would never have seen anywhere else. I mean, there was a lot of choices on TV. In other parts of the country, you didn't have four channels. You might have had one, or you might have not had one that would come in clearly. Here, he could get a lot of TV, and that was really pivotal in his artistic development. Jim loved television. He loved the idea that what you were seeing in your house in Maryland was going on in New York City or in Los Angeles. He loved that idea.